Hi, welcome to another installment of the Inside ETF video series by ETF.com. I'm your host, Drew Voros, editor-in-chief of ETF.com, and my guest today is Ron Bundy, head of Global Strategic Accounts with FTSE Russell. Welcome, Ron.
Thank you for having me, Drew.
FTSE Russell is one of the big boys in the world. Why is it important for them to be at Inside ETFs?
Well, Inside ETFs is a great conference for us because you bring the entire ecosystem of the ETF, you know, world all together in one place. So I get to sit here and have a conversation with you. A lot of our big issuer clients are here.
Right.
The presentations themselves are really great. From first-time users of ETFs that want to get that baseline education, all the way through power users of ETFs and portfolio builders of ETFs.
Right.
There's something here in these sessions really for everybody. And we have all of the industry constituents from almost every segment of the ETF ecosystem, you know, here today, you know, you're here with us this week, you know, for two or three days. So it's been really great.
So just for people who don't know, you're an index provider.
Yes.
And we've seen a lot of crazy things going on in the economy over the last year. Most of it positive, tax cuts. Unfortunately, we had a temporary government shutdown.
Right.
Stocks at all-time high. The economy's kicking in. How does that affect an index provider's approach to, I don't know, rebalancing? Or do you digest that? You let things play out? You just ignore it? How do you approach these kind of macro events?
That's an excellent question, Drew. So FTSE Russell has over $15 trillion of assets benchmarked to our indexes, equities, fixed income, other asset classes. So we really have a global view of a multi-asset capability of what's happening in the world markets. And when you have things like the government shutdown, which surprisingly wasn't even a blip in the markets, right?
Right.
And what we call the Trump bump. So when Trump got elected, you know, president, the small cap companies in the Russell 2000 went on a tear. And now the Russell 2000 is at an all-time high. And things like the tax cuts, even though we don't specifically make changes to our indexes based on these events, the major role of the index provider is to measure the performance of the markets up and down.
Right.
But like with the tax cuts, what we're seeing is the potential for those smaller cap Russell 2000 domestic companies to really benefit from those tax cuts. It's going to have a big impact for them potentially, and that could potentially be good news for investors.
Do small caps benefit more from the tax cut than large caps, or is it across the board and small caps needed that kind of boost?
That's a great question. So if you look at the large cap Russell 1000 companies,
right,
roughly 45-47% of those revenues are overseas.
Mm-hmm.
So they're already paying a lower tax rate, right?
Gotcha.
If you take a look at the Russell 2000 companies, a lot of those are very domestic players. Majority of their revenue comes from within the United States. So a much bigger portion of their revenues are going to benefit from these tax cuts versus some of the mega players who are much more multinational. So yeah, I think it could be a really interesting time for the small cap Russell 2000 companies.
We're at all-time highs across the board, small cap, mid cap, large cap. Again, if it was on the other side of the coin where we're at all-time lows, does that affect you at all, or do you have to maintain that index discipline, if you will?
We do the same thing every single day, whether markets are up or markets are down. What we do is we measure the markets, we report out to our clients, sometimes daily, sometimes in real time, if one of our indexes is basis of an ETF. And the most important thing that an index provider can do is provide accurate, timely information on what's happening in the market today. And whether markets are up or markets are down, quality of delivery, timeliness of delivery, accuracy of delivery is the three things we focus on for our clients every day.
Let's move on to another topic. You're the new incoming chairman of the Index Industry Association, IIA. I'm not sure if a lot of people know what that is. Fairly new. Tell me a little bit about, it's an industry association. What is the goal? What's the purpose? What's the mission?
Yeah, it's great. So the Index Industry Association is a relatively new association developed over the last 5 years, bringing together industry, a global representation of index providers. So we have, you know, Hang Seng Stock Exchange was our latest addition.
So this is global.
To the members. It's a global network.
Gotcha.
14 member firms. It's a really important group on two fronts. First and foremost, we talk about education. All of us in the financial services industry need to provide education on our products and what we deliver and how they and how they play out in the markets. That's first and foremost for us as industry participants, and that the IIA education really is at the forefront of what we do. But we're also an advocacy group for the industry. So, for example, when the LIBOR situation blew up in Europe, and the regulators were getting involved in trying to figure out how to deal with that going forward, the Index Industry Association took a leadership role with the regulators to kind of explain and help make sense of how LIBOR is constructed as an index, and how very different an equity or fixed income indexes are constructed.
Right.
And being that resource for the regulators, I think helped expedite a solution, and the EU, you know, BMR, the benchmark regulations in Europe, now I think they've done a good job of bringing that together with help with associations like the Index Industry Association.
But this is not a political lobby?
Absolutely not a political.
So it's purely industry association, education, and if anything, you work with regulators on solving problems?
That's right. It's an association designed to benefit all, you know, the entire ecosystem of index users from an education and advocacy standpoint.
Well, thank you, Ron, for your time. I hope you're enjoying the conference. And I hope everybody out there will check out ETF.com's Inside ETF video series. I've been the host today, Drew Varos, ETF.com editor-in-chief. Thank you.